This was contained in the final report of the Nakawa-Naguru land allocations that was processed by a select ad hoc committee chaired by the Kazo MP, Dan Kimosho. In the report, lawmakers ruled that the said officers vacate office with immediate effect.
We observed that ULC acted in non-transparent manner. It indeed acted in a manner devoid of integrity, expected of a public entity. As a result, entities and individuals who had capacity to develop the land were deprived of the information and knowledge of the land availability. The committee further established that ULC does not have formal criteria.
Ministers who were on that committee had started making some small portions of trying to create that satellite city into a slum. So, right, Honorable Speaker, I think to me, Honorable Namuganza has a responsibility, and she must tell this House how it happened. But right, Honorable Speaker, I cannot agree with members who are saying the matter should be referred to the IGG.
It also recommends that the State Minister for Lands in charge of urban housing be held accountable for abuse of office on grounds that she used her office to push for illegal allocation of land to some investors.
Honorable Namuganza passes. Abused her office and authority by directing ULC to allocate land to entities while purporting to be communicating a presidential directive which were non-existent. Right Honourable Speaker and Honourable Colleagues, recommendations. In light of the above findings, the committee recommends that Honourable Persis Namuganza be held accountable for abuse of office, for misreading ULC into allocation of land to individuals and entities following presidential directives which were non-existent.
They are presidential directives. Do you act as they are or you act within the law?
Thank you very much, Right Honourable Speaker. Right Honourable Speaker and Honourable Colleagues, when you receive a presidential directive, you determine what provisions of the law are available for you to implement it. So you implement them in accordance.
Parliament has adopted the report with recommendations that the Minister Namuganza relinquishes office.
Authority to temporarily relieve Honorable Namuganza passes of her duties to pave way for investigations by the relevant organs of government. The committee noted that the undue interference by ministers and other government officials in the process leading to re-entry of the Nakawa-Naguru land portrayed government in bad light and resulted in two financial loss upon the ministers being found of contempt of court and being ordered to pay 50 million, a cost that was borne by government.
Furious, Persis Namuganza has trashed the committee findings and wondered why they zeroed in on her alone, yet there were other key players in the Naguru bonanza.
It's not in any way that it violates any law in this Uganda. Any person, even an ordinary citizen, can recommend anyone to get land from government. And if the person has capacity to develop that land, they do. They go ahead and develop the land. So it's unfortunate that some people are trying to tarnish. Some of us, we have really made our good names. We have been away from corruption. But people feel so bad that why is it that for her she does not have any corruption allegation on her names?
She scoffed at parliamentary committees for being used to fight personal wars, which is going to tarnish the image of the 11th parliament.
Come up with a method which is so silly that they will be using parliamentary committees to tarnish people's images that will lower the decorum of this parliament. I want to appeal to the members of the 11th parliament that they should not allow certain elements amongst us who each hate each other to be used, because the public is out there watching. I don't think that this is proper, but anyway, they have made their recommendations good enough that their report has come out, which is full of biasness. We shall go and see to the executive, the good thing, the president who has been chairing some of these meetings is there.